नदी किनारे दो वृक्षा एक मोहवा इतिहास, एक नीचे दो तपसी एक लक्ष्मण एक राम। लायो जिया जान, अब लायो जिया जान, जाने की ना लायो लायो जिया जान, लायो जिया जान की, अब लायो जिया जान की, लायो जिया जान की पिया, लायो जिया जान की, अब लायो जिया जान की, जाने की ना लायो पिया लायो जिया जान, अब जाने की ना लायो पिया लायो।
Yeah. शक्ति की आधार पापनाष्टिने कारने महाकाली अवतार पापनाष्टिने कारने महाकाली अवतार। सुनो मेरे देवी काली भवानी, काली भवानी देवी काली भवानी। सुनो मेरे देवी काल भवानी, काल भवानी देवी काल भवानी, काल भवानी देवी काल भवानी, काल भवानी देवी काल भवानी। बोलो सुनो मेरे देवी काल भवानी, काल भवानी माँ काली भवानी। भद्रा काली नाम भी तेरा, जय का तेरी पापम साने। भद्रा काली नाम भी तेरा, जय का तेरी हे नाथ निवारी। सुनो मेरे देवी काल भवानी, काल भवानी बोलो। सुनो देवी काल भवानी, काल भवानी महाकाली, ओ महाकाली 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 महाकाली। तू ही कंगे तू ही अंबे, तू ही जगदंबे महारानी। बोलो देवी काल भवानी, काल भवानी महाकाल भवानी, काल भवानी देवी काल भवानी, काल भवानी देवी काल भवानी। कष्ट कठिन है दूरा हटारी, लक्ष्कर सबके प्राणी प्राणी। कष्ट कठिन है दूरा हटारी, लक्ष्कर सबके प्राणी। भवानी माँ काल भवानी, तुम देवी काल भवानी काल भवानी काल everybody महाकाली 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 हे महाकाली
प्रेम सुनो आज शक्ति भवानी माता की
जय।
प्यावर संजनो आप लोग खड़ा हो जाए देवी मैया की आरती के लिए। लेट अस ऑल स्टैंड एज़ हैव देवी आरती।
अरे सुनो मोरी देवी पर्वत वासिनी तेरा पारण पाया तेरा पारण पाया। गाओ
मोरी देवी पर्वत वासिनी तेरा पारण पाया तेरा पारण पाया।
गाओ सुनो मोरी देवी पर्वत वासिनी तेरा पारण पाया तेरा पारण पाया।
सुनो मेरी देवी पर्वतवासिनी तेरा पारण पाया तेरा पारण पाया।
पान सुपारी भजा नारियर
पान सुपारी भजा
अरे पान सुपारी ध्वजा नारियर
पान सुपारी ध्वजा नारियर।
अरे लई तेरे भेंट चढ़ाया लई तेरे भेंट चढ़ाया रे मैया।
हाँ पर्वतवासिनी तेरा पार न पाया तेरा पार न पाया।
सुहा चोली तेरी अंग बिराजे सुहा चोली तेरे अंग बिराजे अरे केसर तिलक लगाया केसर तिलक लगाया। गाओ
जय भगवती पर्वतवासिनी तेरा पार न पाया तेरा पार न पाया।
नंगे पाँव तेरे अकबर आकर अरे नंगे पाँव तेरे अकबर आकर अरे सोने के छत्र चढ़ाया सोने के छत्र
चढ़ाया।
हाँ
जय
पर्वत बना देवालय
ऊंचे ऊंचे पर्वत बना
देवालय
ऊंचे ऊंचे पर्वत बना देवालय।
अरे नीचे शहर बसाया
नीचे शहर बसाया।
गाओ
मेरी देवी पर्वत
परहे तेरी
द्वारे
ब्रह्मा वेद परहे तेरे द्वारे
ब्रह्मा वेद परहे तेरे द्वारे।
अरे शंकर ध्यान लगाया शंकर
सतयुगत्रेता
द्वापर मधे अरे कलयुग राज सवाया
कलयुग
अरे मोहन भोग लगाया मैया मोहन भोग लगाया
सुनो मेरी देवी पर्वत वासनी तेरा पार न पाया तेरा पार न पाया
भानु भगत मैया तेरे गुण गावे अरे भानु भगत मैया तेरे गुण गावे अरे मन वांछित फल पाया मन वांछित फल पाया रे मैया
सुनो मेरी देवी पर्वत वासनी तेरा पार न पाया तेरा पार न पाया
अरे
सुनो मेरी देवी पर्वत वासनी तेरा पार न पाया तेरा पार न पाया
सुनो मेरी देवी पर्वत वासनी तेरा पार न पाया तेरा पार न पाया अरे तेरा पार न पाया अरे तेरा पार न पाया
प्रेम से लो भगवती मैया की
जय
अपना आसन लीजिए बैठ जाइए कैन हैव योर सीट नाउ माय फ्रेंड्स सो वेलकम टू आवर यज्ञा वंस अगेन एज वी कंटिन्यू आवर दिस ईयर एट नाइट्स ऑफ प्रवचन कथा फ्रॉम श्रीमद देवी भागवतम थ्रू ऑल द काइंड कर्टेसीज ऑफ ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ द मंदिर ऑल द काइंड स्पॉन्सर्स हू हैव मेड इट पॉसिबल This evening we continue again in celebrating the Divine Mother. Coincidentally, today is my wife's birthday and all too, so more cake and things afterwards. Well, if all you get sugar, don't blame me. It is sweetness of God. Let us now, you know, clasp our hands and close our eyes as we meditate upon that Divine Mother of the universe. As we ask her blessings upon all of us, as you all join together with love as a family. There is none high and there is none low, there is none rich and there is none poor. In the house of the Lord, we are all but children. None is old and none is young. We are all divine souls. We are divine sparks of love and divinity. As we all join as the children of that one supreme Bhagwan who has manifested as Mother Durga, let us all pray together, begging her grace and blessings upon us all. Begging her mercies upon us as we invite her in the tabernacle of our hearts.
Hari Om Sri Ganeshaya Namaha Sri Saraswatyai Namaha Shri Ramachandraya Namaha ॐ नमः शिवाय दुर्गा देवी नमोस्तु ते लक्ष्मी माता नमोस्तु ते काली माता नमोस्तु ते गंगा मैया नमोस्तु ते ओम एकर दन गज बदन के भगवंतौ कर जोरे कृपा करहु शिवनंदना, बुद्धि बढ़ई जहि मोरी। व्यास आदि नर पुंगवा, नारद आदि मुनि स, दिनकर ब्रह्मा शेष गुरु, सब कहनाओ शीस। जयंती मंगला काली, भद्रकाली कपालिनी, दुर्गा क्षमा शिवा धात्री, स्वाहा स्वधा नमोस्तुते। जय त्वं देवी चामुंडे, जय भूतार्तिहारिणी, जय सर्वगते देवी, कालरात्रि नमोस्तुते। ओम दुम दुर्गायै नमः, ओम दुम दुर्गायै नमः, ओम दुम दुर्गायै नमः, ओम शांति शांति शांति।
देवी मैया की
जय।
सो यू नो पीपल हैव कम एंड गिवन डोनेशंस टू कीप दिस यजना गोइंग। इट डजंट कॉस्ट अ फ्यू डॉलर्स, इट कॉस्ट थाउजेंड्स एंड थाउजेंड्स ऑफ डॉलर्स वेल। एंड आई हैव सीन, एंड दोज ऑफ यू हैव बीन विद अस इन द मंदिर एंड कमिंग टू यजना हैव सीन दिस फेस्टिवल ग्रो फ्रॉम अ वेरी हम्बल फेस्टिवल इनटू आई थिंक नियरली a nationwide festival. And we have devotees coming from abroad even to join with us. This evening my father gave me a letter, an envelope, and we are grateful that Mrs. Jacqueline Passard and family of 28 Durbasa Trace San Francisco, looking on television, on Sankhya TV, she sent a donation to assist us in performing the Kumari Puja. So we are, may Bhagwan bless you, and to all of those who have given. This evening, my in-laws are sitting with my wife to perform Puja, and those of you sitting on those chairs, it was all donated by my father-in-law for the benefit of Dharma. And when you go to eat at the back there, all those tables and chairs you see there, the plastic ones, he gave all of that we can have comfort in the mandir. Next year he will be giving a Devi Murti. Today, you know, I came a little late because my wife didn't dare dress me. Because today was her birthday. Isha is her birthday and she is sitting to perform puja. But we are doing worship today. And before I enter into Katha, I told you we will sing Pachra. In the Uttar Pradesh region and Bihar region of the India, when we worship to Devi, it is like this. In my ancestral village, my uncle sponsors the murti, Pandit Taluka Prasad Dubey. He sponsors a murti for the whole village. And my family in India is doing the same as I am doing. And this is a tradition for the past 300 years. And when they go to worship to the Devi, there are beautiful bhajans that are sung in the lingua franca or the language of the people called Bhojpuri. Devi Mata is called Bhagavati in Hindi, in Sanskrit. In Bhojpuri, say Bhagavati. She sits in Vindhyachal mountain. There Hanumanji is guarding and Bhagwan Krishna is playing the Basuri for her. Because why? Devi Mata is considered the sister of Lord Krishna. So we sing together.
माई भगवती विंध्यवासिनी पहरे के हनुमान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान माई भगवती विंध्यवासिनी पहरे के हनुमान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान विंध्याचल है निर्मल टोला लगता माँ का सुंदर मेला हाँ विंध्याचल है निर्मल टोला लगता माँ का सुंदर मेला मणि दीप है धकी नगरी भगत करे गुणगान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान माई भगवती विंध्यवासिनी पहरे के हनुमान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान काली खो में काली माई सीता कुट देखे लज्जा भाई काली खो में काली माई सीता कुट देखे लज्जा भाई वहां जहां झरना का पानी निर्मल है अस्थान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान माई भगवती विंध्यवासिनी पहरे के हनुमान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान अष्टभुजी का दर्शन कैलू भैरोनाथ के मन में धैलू अष्टभुजी का दर्शन कैलू भैरोनाथ के मन में धैलू जीवन भर का पाप कटे कैले गंगा स्नान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान माई भगवती विंध्यवासिनी पहरे के हनुमान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान बंसी तेर रहे भगवान बंसी तेर रहे
जैन There's a beautiful place called Vindhyachal. It is in the city called Mirzapur, close to Banaras, but 2-3 hours away. That is close, because India is a big country. And there it is said when Lord Krishna had taken advent, and the Devi had taken advent in the house of Yashoda Mata, and the babies were exchanged, you know the katha. When Kansa was about to smite this baby girl and kill her, she flew out of his hand. And she said, your death is born. And she disappeared in a flash of lightning, bijli. It is told, when she disappeared, this happened in the Mathura, close to Delhi. When she disappeared, her crown fell to earth. And that crown is still there in Delhi. There is a mandir, which is a very small mandir, not very, you know, known and beautiful as other mandirs that you may see in India. A very simple but spiritual place where the mukut of that Durga fell. I had been blessed to get the opportunity to take some people to that place where the crown of the Devi fell, and the crown is still there. And people go and sit there and they recite Durga Saptashati, the 700 of verses of Devi Ma. Her body became like lightning and she went into the Vindhyachal and sat. There her footprints, her feet prints are there, both feet are there. And you people go on that mountain which is close to the Ganga, as this bhajan is telling, a very pure, beautiful place. And people go up into the Vindhyachal to see the Devi. There is a place of Bhairo Baba. But before you go to that mandir of Vindhyachal, there is Kali Kho. It's like a little cave you have to go inside to perform puja. Together with my wife and my father and mother and my daughter, we were able to sit and perform puja and give charity to Kali Mata in Kali Kho. Very beautiful place. And you get to go and see the Divine Mother. I am lucky that because of my uncle, I was able to be taken straight into the room where devotees will pass. The pundits took me inside and put my head on the footprint of the Devi. And I have been lucky. Every time I go to India, my uncle always carry me to go and take darshan and put my head on the feet of the Devi. Your religion is not a story. Your religion is not a fable or a mythology. It's history. I have seen the power of the Devi. I have experienced going to the various Shakti Peeth in India and see the miracle of the Devi through the devotion of her children. When people will line up for miles and miles and miles just to see her, that tells me she is alive. That is a miracle. When I go to Chintapurni, Naina Devi, Jwalamukhi, Bagla Devi, you get in the ecstasy of divinity when you see devotees by the big busloads coming, like one whole village, making pilgrimage, spending a night on the road, sleeping on the road, on the side of the road, cooking on the road, and going village, mandir to mandir, and singing and dancing and chanting. They're not bothered about anything. They're just in the ecstasy of the divine. We don't have to go all over. We just go to our own mandirs and worship and turn your mandir into a Shakti Peeth, a place of power and divinity. You can do that. Tonight, my friends, I'm going to talk about Dharma and Kaliyuga. Many people, you're hearing stories about Kaliyuga, about what is Satyuga, what is Treta, what is Dwapar, what is Kali. Why are we living in Kali? People want to know, why are we in Kali? What are the qualities of the people in Kali, and why are people prone to do wrong thing in Kali? And we always ask ourselves, why people behaving so? Sometimes we lie on our beds, sometimes I lie for hours thinking, why people just do these things? And still, like, I get in mad thinking about it, so I stop thinking. What will motivate a person. But you know, I saw this katha. And this is the katha. Tonight you may not learn about the Devi more so, but you are learning about yourselves, why things are happening to you, why the world is going the way it's going. And it teaches us how to understand it, accept it, but also how to be liberated from it. Because we cannot control what is happening. People cannot control their thoughts, your anger, your hatred, your jealousy, you name it. Why? Raja Janmejay. He is speaking to Vyas Muni, having his satsang. What is Raja Janmejay asking as we chant? Sri Durga Sharanam Mama.
Sri Durga Sharanam Mama. Sri Durga Sharanam Mama. Sri Durga Sharanam Mama. Sri Durga Sharanam Mama. Sri Durga Sharanam Mama. Sri Durga Sharanam Mama. Sri Durga Sharanam Mama. Sri Durga Sharanam Mama.
Bharat avataranarthaya gathitam janma krishnayo samshayoyam veja shrestha hridaye mama tishtati gao
Durga sharanam mama Shri Durga sharanam mama
prithvi ko swarupena brahmanam sharanam gata वापराते दीदीना आर्त गुरु भरपतीत
श्री दुर्गा शरणम ममा 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 श्री दुर्गा शरणम
नमो नारायणाय कृष्ण गोविंदाय नमो नमः। जन्मे जय ने कहा कि हे द्विजेंद्र, आपने कहा है कि पृथ्वी का भार हरण करने के निमित्त राम और कृष्णचंद्र जी ने जन्म ग्रहण किया था। उस विषया का मेरे हृदय में बड़ा संशय उपस्थित हुआ है। राजा जन्मे जय स्पीकिंग विथ Vyas Muni, O Dvijendra, O highest among all Brahmins, tell me, you have told to me that Shri Ram and Krishna Bhagwan came to earth to relieve the earth of sinfulness, to take away this weight from this earth, sinfulness. Vaha aap suniye, dwapar yug ke अवसान में पृथ्वी भारी पाप से आक्रांत और कातर हो गो रूप धारण कर ब्रह्मा जी के शरणागत हुई थी।
इफ दिस इज माई कंफ्यूजन गॉड व्यास मुनि, इफ द लॉर्ड केम टू टेक अवे द सिंस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, व्हाई एट द एंड ऑफ द्वापर, व्हाई एट द एंड ऑफ द्वापर युग मदर अर्थ took the form of a cow and went to Brahma to beg him for help. If God take away the sin from the world, why is there sinfulness then? Then in Kali Yuga, she shouldn't have any problem. She shouldn't go and beg for help. If God destroys the sinners, why is there still sin? Why are people doing so many wrong things? Jab Brahma ji prithvi ke sahit bhubhar haran aur sadhun की रक्षा के निमित्त कमलापति प्रभु विष्णु के निकट जाए प्रार्थना कर कहने लगा लगे कि हे विभो, आप पृथ्वी में वसुदेव के घर अवतार रूप से शीघ्र जन्म ग्रहण कीजिए। इफ दिस वॉज द कॉज दैट इफ द लॉर्ड केम ऑन अर्थ टू
take away sins. Then why dirty matter have to come like a cow, go to Brahmaji, and then take Brahma and all the holy beings and go to Vaikunth and bawl and cry and say, God, Jaya Jaya Binasi, Sab Ghat Basi, Pranat Pal Bhagavanta, Gaudvija Hitkari, Jaya Surari. You know, why? Why is it? Can you not tell me? If this is the cause that the Lord has come on earth to free us from sins, free us from troubles, free us from the pains of karma, then tell me, highest of all Brahmins, tell me then, why is it that Dharti Mata has to pain herself and cry like this? Can you explain to me?
Jaya Jaya Sura Nayak, Sab Sukha Dayak, Pranat Pal Bhagavanta, Gaudvija Hitkari, Jaya Surari, Sindhu Suta Priya Kanta, Palan Sura Dharani, Adabhut Karani, Varman Dani, सहज कृपाला दीन दयाला करहु कृपा जय जय अविनाशी सब घट व्यापी पापक परमानंदा अवगत गोतीता चरितर पुनीता माया रहित मुकुंदा
Why is it that they're crying to you, that you are the one who sab ghat basi? Ghat mean your heart. Basi mean reside. O Lord, who resides in the heart of everyone. If the Lord resides in the heart of everyone, then are you a sinner? Are you impure if God is in you? This is what Brahmaji is telling the Lord. If you are residing in everybody, come and help me. You are the Lord who is Sabhagata Basi. Let no one come and tell you are a sinner. Let no one come and tell you need to be saved, because if God is living in me, I already saved. But because of my ignorance, I do not realize I am saved. You know, like sometimes you reach in a place and you reach, but me no reach? That is the ignorance. You sleep away and you wake up and but I reach. Well, you're sleeping and you're liberated. That is why you don't know you're liberated. You don't have to die to be liberated, because once you recognize you are divine, once you recognize you are pure, once you recognize you are the child of the divine, then there is no sin anymore. Because you will begin to live in a pure and loving way like the divine Lord. You'll really be your father's child. You'll be your mother's child. You'll behave like your parent, the Supreme Brahman. They have a saying Vaise putter, vaise, you know, bap, jaise bap. How the son is, just so the father is. As how the father is, just so the son is. Jaise bap, vaise putter. How the father is, so the son comes. So if you must be like your parents, then be like your supreme parents. Once you recognize your divinity, then there is no sin. Why? How could that be? So I just kill a man and you're telling me once I know God, I don't sin? Yes. Once you know God, then there is a transformation in your life. Once you are conscious always of divinity, then you will not sin anymore. The way to become redeemed of your sinfulness is to stop doing this sinful action. Stop having the sinful thought. That is redemption. Some people fool yourself and thinking, I will change my religion or something, and I will become saved, but the mind still the same way, the action still the same way, just the place of worship change. So you just a hypocrite. Religion cannot liberate you. Religion is the guide to keep you on the pathway towards liberation. Religion will, I want to know which religion liberate anybody. Religion only takes you like to a ceiling. Beyond that, you have to develop yourself. Religion keeps you. Religion guides you. Religion protects you. And then through your guidance and protection from religion, you will then evolve spiritually and become liberated. Religion is not about fighting one another and saying, I'm better than you, and we see this in the world today. The true religion is love and acceptance. Universal love, unconditional love. That is what Sanatan Dharma preaches. This is why when you go to India, you don't see one kind of people. You see some people looking like white people, you see some people looking like Chinese people, you see some people all different color, rainbow nation. Yet Hinduism is beyond race. Sanatan Dharma has expanded itself in the ancient time that even in the Philippines, they worship Sri Ram. In the Philippines, they have their own Ramayana. In Indonesia, they worship to Sri Ram, they worship to Ganga Mata, they worship to Surya Dev. In Thailand, they worship to Ganesh Bhagwan, they worship to Mahalakshmi Mata. One of the biggest statues of Lord Ganesh is in Thailand. He's lying down, over 150 feet long. Lying down. The king of Thailand is a Hindu. They say that they are the descendant of Sri Ram, and their surname is Rama. In Korea, thousands and thousands of Korean people go to Ayodhya every year to pay respect to Sri Ram. Because in the ancient time, a princess from Ayodhya was sent to get married to a king of Korea. And so they say, we are from the Rama blood. And they always go back to Ayodhya. Chinese looking people, South Korean people, they're going to Ayodhya every year because they come from there. They say, this is our heritage. In Bihar, thousands and thousands of Chinese people and Oriental people come to India to worship to the Gautam Buddha in Gaya. Beautiful mandirs, golden mandirs, jewel-studded mandirs are built by wealthy people from all over the world who go there to see where Gautam Buddha sat under the Bodhi tree. You know, Bodhi tree is what? A peepal tree. He sat under that peepal tree. Dulari, you went with me. You see it? And that peepal tree, the same spot from over 2,500 years ago, the peepal tree has died, but it grows back on the same spot. And there is where Gautam Buddha sat. And people from all over the world go there day and night and sit and do meditation. Did you not see that? And you feel the vibration of the divinity of these people. India has taught the world religion. And I make no apology for saying it. India has civilized the world. If not directly, but by inspiration, indirectly. Some of the greatest Hindu scholars were Chinese who came into India and studied Sanatan Dharma and went back into China and preached it. As I said, tomorrow I'm going to tell you about Durga Devi being worshipped.
in every religion, in every culture. Understand that we do not have to fight any religion. We don't have to fight any race, because we are all one family. So we come back to the Katha. Why is it that the God has to go and beg, Brahma has to beg Lord Vishnu to come again and again? Why? If the Lord has come already to take away sins. As we chant Sri Durga Sharanam Mama, let us listen. Durga Devi Ki!
Sri Durga Sharanam Mama, 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 Sri Durga Sharanam Mama,
Sri Durga Sharanam Mama, Sri Durga Sharanam निकषः ज्ञात्वा सर्वान् दुरा सारान् पाप बुद्धि नृपा नहि
श्रीदुर्गा शरणं मम श्रीदुर्गा शरणं मम
हतो भीष्मो धृतो द्रोण विराटो द्रुपदस्तथा वसीत सोमचक्रकर्णो
उन्होंने इस पृथ्वी में अनेक दुष्ट स्वभाव पुरुषों को और अनेक राजाओं को पाप बुद्धि और दुराचारी जानकर उनको मार कुछेक पृथ्वी का भार दूर किया था। जन्मेजय स्थली इनफैक्ट व्हेन द लॉर्ड केम ही किल ऑल हिज विशस इविल माइंडेड लीडर्स ही डिस्ट्रॉयड देम ऑल। इसमें भीष्म द्रोण विराट द्रुपद वाहलिक सोमदत्त और सूर्य का पुत्र करण मारे गए थे। ही किल ऑल हिज ग्रेट वॉरियर्स ऑल हिज ग्रेट लीडर्स भीष्म द्रोण विराट राजा द्रुपद वाहलिक सोमदत्त एंड करण। किंतु जिन्होंने धन लूट तथा हरि की रमणी गणों को हरण किया था वह संपूर्ण करोड़ करोड़ आभीर शक मलेच और निषाद गण पृथ्वी में शेष रहे। बुद्धिमान कृष्ण ने यदि उनका नाम मारा तो उनका पृथ्वी भार दूर करना किस प्रकार हुआ? But if he had killed all his king, why is it then that after all these evil people came and started to plunder and loot? People like the Abhiras, the Shakas, the Malech, the Nisad, all these wicked and vicious people came into India and began to loot and to cause so much trouble for our people. If the Lord had destroyed the sin, why is it that sinful people are still there and causing havoc? Sometimes you ask yourself this thing, why? If God is God, why is it that every time he have to come? Why don't he just make good people alone and destroy badness, evilness, sinfulness? You ask yourself this. Hinduism only have God coming and going, God coming and going. Why God don't just put a stop to it? Well, there's a reason. There's a reason. Oh, Vyas Muni, when I see the people in this Kali Yuga, I see they are all addicted to sinfulness. And this is why I am in doubt if God really comes to remove the load of sin from her. We ask, gee, listening, and this is a question many of us who ponder religion thinking, why? So we ask, gee, is now answering that question. It's an answer for us all to understand our situation in this life and what we must do in this life, not to stop what is happening, but to save ourselves. As we chant Sri Durga Sharanam Mama, let us hear what happened. Durga Devi ki jai.
Sri Durga Sharanam Mama. Sri Durga Sharanam Mama.
Sri Durga Sharanam Mama.
Sri Durga Sharanam Mama.
Sri Durga Sharanam Mama.
धर्मार्थरसिकाये तु ते नैत्रेतयुगे भवन्तौ
श्री दुर्गा शरणं मम 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 श्री दुर्गा शरणं
व्यास जी बोले कि हे महाराज, काल के वशीभूत हो जिस युग में जिस प्रकार स्वभाव आदि युक्त प्रजा उत्पन्न होती है, अन्यथा भाव कभी नहीं होता। युग धर्म को इस विषय का उसका विशेष कारण जानना चाहिए। लिसन राजा, व्हाई यू थिंकिंग दिस? लिसन, लेट मी गिव यू आंसर। देयर आर फोर युगस, and each yug have its own dharma, its own kind of law. And so when the age comes, this type of people will be born with this type of mentality. You wouldn't find people who behaving like we, all of us, living in Satyug, or Dwapar, or Treta, or Ninkali. All of us living here, we are not qualified. You know that? We come like when you're, you know, when they boil chocolate tea, like it dregs below. We eat the dregs. No, I'll make it simple for you to understand. Because we had the chance over the ages to evolve and become liberated, but we still decide we want to be like when they boil coffee or they boil chocolate tea. You remain like it dregs below. So we remain for the last age. We're still hoping. Why? Everyone thinks differently in every age. That is why in Satyug there is Satyug Dharma. The modus operandi for people in Satyug. In Treta, there's a different way of thinking. He's explaining. This is why we have what you may think were bad people then in one age. Compare them to what is happening now, is worse now. And he begins to explain that people who are devoted to religion, dharma, and dharma alone, they are born in Satyug. People who love to pray, whose mind is only God and everything is God, nothing is about hate, hurt, anything like that. Their life is only about divinity and serving God, worshipping God, praising God. 24 hours a day. Some of you fed up. Some of you say, so long you go fast. So long you pray. Sometimes people mock you. When you pray and I say, what happened? God must be fed up here, you. But this is the innate quality of man to want to devote himself to God at all times in thought, word, and deed. And those who have this quality, only they are born in Satyug. They don't even think for one iota of a second, I want to hate anyone or any negative, nothing at all, only God. Those who like religion, are fond of religion, like to pray and the very prayerfulness, but they like money, they are born in Treta. Treta was the age of kings. So you want to pray to God, but you know, I want something feasible as well. I want money. So those who have desire for money, but have desire for God, they will be born in Treta Yuga. And those who have desire to worship to God, they like money and they want to spend the money, go holiday, enjoy dharma, earth and calm. Who want dharma, righteousness? They want plenty money and they want to spend the money to go holiday, go enjoyment, luxury. They are born in Dwapar, the age of Bhagwan Krishna. Bhagwan Krishna came and lived amongst the people as a king in lavish environments, in luxury. That is what he's telling. But those who want wealth and are very lustful, they are born in Kali Yuga. Everybody only wants. Everybody cannot control their desires, and this is what is destroying your spirituality. You want money and you want to fulfill the lust. The lust, and we're seeing it in the society. So I talk plain, you know. People like get addicted to sex. Plain talk, good manners. If I don't tell you, nobody will tell you that. Because they're addicted to sex. That brings down your spirituality. You're addicted to money. This is why we see what is happening today in our country. We take a leave at Kathan, go and look at our society today in Trinidad. How many houses have been broken? Relationships have been destroyed. Everybody wants to marry a Spanish now. Mi Elaine.
Hola, hola.
Just because they say flower bad, that doesn't mean you have to marry the lady to eat corn roti. You could make corn roti home. Only na bhai corn roti? Makkai. If you get in milk, you don't buy the cow. So why are you going to marry the Spanish girl for? Why leaving your wife to call Spanish people? This is happening every day in our society. These people only coming to fleece you, you know. This is Kali Yuga Maya. And leave you with AIDS. And then you're going to know what happened. So check yourself and stay in your marriage. Make it happen. Make it work. Only failures have failed marriages. Only failures have failed marriages. Devil and, they say, filler and paint could make the devil look like a saint, you know. So coming back to the Katha, this is why we are born in Kali Yuga, because we are lustful. From past life we have developed lustfulness, erotic desires, carnal desires. So you want money to fund your desires. So you cannot be born in Dwapar, you cannot be born in Treta, you cannot be born in Satyug. You have to be born all the way, you have to be born in Kali Yuga. Is it that we now are cursed people? Are we going to be put aside and sent to hell, all of us now? Vyas Muni is speaking as we chant Sri Durga Sharanam Mama. Let us listen.
Sri Durga Sharanam
Vyas Muni is telling, these are the characteristics of the ages. But please note, there is the Lord of Dharma who rules over everything, yet Adharma is also present. Righteousness and unrighteousness is always present in the world. O King, the pious people, the high-souled, high-thinking people, they are born in Satyug. Where are the munis now who have devoted to charity and doing good in Treta and Dwapar? And tell me, O King of Rishis, Vyas Muni, where are those sinful people, those merciless people? Where will they go when they expire? You are the one who knows this all. Tell me, where do the high souls people go? Those people dedicated to charity and building society, where do they go? And those merciless, evil-minded, selfish, self-motivated people, where do they go? And Vyas Muni says, Oh Janmejay, persons born in Satyug perform acts of spirituality of high merit, and they, when they leave this world, they go to Devalok. They go to the realm of the Devtas. They become like the Devtas. They could be Brahmin, Kshatri, Vaishya, Sudra, of any caste. Anyone, once they perform service to Bhagwan wholeheartedly, body, mind and soul, without thinking anything else, they will attain liberation. They will go to the highest realm in Satyug. By the virtue of charity, mercy, listen carefully, I want to say it in Hindi and I want to say it in Sanskrit, because people will think that I just want to say something. He says, Satyam daya tatha danam swadara gamanam tatha. I was reading it slow so people will know and they will tell you, yes, the Pandit said it from the book. Adroha sarva bhuteshu samata sarva jantushu. That's the 21st verse, and it says here in Hindi, Satya Daya Dan Swadara Gaman Ahimsa, aur sab jeevon ke prati saman bhav se daya, yah sab sadharan dharam acharan karke, vah dharam ke
वसले संपूर्ण रज कादि नीच वर्ण भी स्वर्ग को जाते हैं। It says here that a person who is virtuous, truthful, merciful, charitable, who is faithful to his wife only. Well, we have to be politically correct, faithful to your husband too. Who is faithful to your spouse. This is what he's telling. Who does not injure animals, who have no jealousy for anyone, who shows mercy to everyone equally. You know, sometimes you show mercy to someone and a little less mercy to another person. Who is samadarshi? Everyone is equal. And practicing this universal form of religion, everyone will become liberated. There is no caste barrier. Everyone will become, because these are the, what is calling? The universal form of religion. Virtue to truth. Say it after me. Say, virtue to truth. Mercy. Charity, faithfulness to one's spouse, non-injury of life, having no jealousy, showing mercy to all equally. Right? These are the universal forms of dharma. If you can follow this, you will become liberated. Some people think, you see, one day Gautam Buddha speaks with his shishyas, his chelas, his shishyas, his disciples, and he says, you must never be lustful. You must never think lustful thoughts. So in the book of the Buddhists, the shishya is telling my guru, what if a beautiful lady passes by? What do we do? Are we not enchanted or enticed by her beauty? He says, yes, everyone will notice the beauty. But if your mind goes beyond that and begin to think more, start pulling back your mind. You just say, oh, that's a beautiful person passing, and you go on. But anytime your mind goes beyond that, you have to pull back your mind. This is control. Always. Pull back your mind from thinking excess thoughts that will not give you spiritual productivity. This is how we must live. If you are not faithful with your spouse, this is a problem, eh? This is why I'm beating this, you know. I'm beating this. And this is why Baba stopped it. My wife had give me no problem, you know. I just give my wife problem. She had to wash and cook. So me and a problem, my wife, I telling you how you have to live, because I see what is happening in society. I am the Vyas. You could do all the charity you want. You could do all the jag you want. You could do all that you think is good that you want to do. But if you're not contented with your husband or your wife, then you will not get liberation. For contentment is a foundation for spiritual advancement. If you break up and you're married back, stay there. Don't look for third and fourth and fifth and sixth and seventh. Karma will bring people together and move them apart. But this institution of marriage was brought to make man civilized, to differentiate man from animal. That is why the institution of marriage was created, to keep you together, to understand. Why are you married? Because the person looking good. I always tell people when I do wedding, they go, have a time, two all you go look like salt prunes, you know, all you go dry up. So if you're married for looks, you go last. No more that Botox, something you could take to help you, you know. You get married for spiritual reason. You bring a man and a woman together. You bring two souls together because you don't have to get married. Let me tell you something. To find God. You could become celibate and find God. But the moment your mind thinking about women, if you're a fella or a girl, you're thinking about fellas, then you have to get married because you will sin. You will sin first in your mind, then you will sin otherwise. So you come together to fulfill each other's physical desires, to assist each other, so you will not go out and be like animals, firstly. But when you get married and you go to do what is called the bhawar, you know the bhawar? When you're going around the marrow and the fire and everything, you're walking a journey with your lover, with your wife, your husband. Your wife leading in front sometime, because plenty time men don't come to mandir. The wife does come to the mandir, and they had to beg their husband to come. And that's why some of your wife don't cook in the evening, so at least you'll come to eat self. You know, so the wife leads because she's telling, both of us, both are telling, in case you are not motivated to move on this spiritual journey that we're taking. It's not a physical journey, you know, a spiritual journey. We are responsible for each other to become liberated. And you have a day you might get dejected. You might feel, no, I've given up. The wife leads. No, I will drag you and carry you. You have to go. I will encourage you to go. And they sometimes, the wife will sometimes get frustrated and give up. And say, man, I fed up too. And the husband will lead. Then you remember when you're walking around? And the husband will lead and say, well, if you can't make it, I will take you. I will encourage you. Sometimes I will force you. Because you have to walk. We make a promise today. And then the seventh time you walk hand in hand together around. We are friends firstly. And we walk together this journey of life as friends. That we help each other. We are each other's well-wisher so that we will become liberated together. We will not die and be separated, but we will meet again in paradise. We will meet again and live forever. That is why the husband put the sindur seven times on the mang of the dulahin. If we don't get liberated in this life, we go married again in the next life. And we're married again in the next life till we will be together liberated. This is the promise we have made. It's not till death do us part, it's till we get liberated. There are beautiful books that speak about this. I wouldn't go into it. Hindus, if you start to read your Hindi language and buy books and start to read, you will understand the beauty of marriage in the literatures of Hinduism and Indian culture. When you read in the Alha of Belaka Gauna and you read how she explains her previous lives, you get tears coming from your eyes. So we come back to Katha. This is why, my friends and young people, don't get misled. Don't leave your dharma and fall into lustfulness. Now, I'm not saying you can't marry nobody and thing. I'm not promoting no racism and thing. But marry someone who will be living a spiritual life, a spiritually and morally motivated life. And if your partner doesn't have these two qualities, then there's no quality in that person. Money and education have no value if your husband or your wife is not spiritually and morally motivated. Understand this well. So when you're looking for good people to marry your children, make sure they come from a good spiritual and moral background. Otherwise, after a few months, tooth guile. So we come back to the Katha, my friends. In Dwapar, in Kali, what happens? Everyone will become liberated if they are following the precepts of Dharma. So too in Treta Yuga, so too in Dwapar Yuga, men go to heaven, people go to heaven by virtue of their merits, by practicing their own Dharma. What does it mean? Whatever is your lifestyle, your occupation, sorry, you'll be liberated by that, because most of the time you're occupied by your occupation. That's why they call it the occupation. You sleep a certain amount of hours, you eat a certain amount of hours, but you work a good bit of hours. That's your occupation. So what is occupying your mind mostly, that is the catalyst for liberation. So if you're cleaning drain, you sing in bhajan. You're planting garden, you sing in bhajan. You know, long ago when they planted rice, they had songs they used to sing when they planted rice. When they're picking rice, they had songs. Why? So people keeping their mind on God. Gita says, through your occupation, you're a lawyer, you're a doctor, you're an accountant, you're a laborer, you're a teacher, you're playing organ, you're singing bhajan. Whatever you're doing, it is a service unto God. So in Treta, in Dwapar, through your own job, you're praying to God. Everything you're doing, keep God in your name, in your mind, God's name in your mind. But what happened in Kali Yuga? What happens to Kali Yuga? In this age of Kali, persons are addicted to viciousness. And because of that, they are going to hell. They're going to hell. What is viciousness? What is viciousness? You have no mercy. Kabir Das, one day, he's explaining who is a human. Everybody say, I'm a human. I'm a bhakta. Look, I put on mala. Look, I have on chandan. Look, I going to puja. Look, I fasting. Look, I praying. Look, I this. Look, I that. And he tell them, Jo nar dayavant soi nar nar hai. Jo nar dayavant soi nar nar hai. Oh, jo nar. Ha! चंदन लगाए से कवन नर डर गए हाँ ए भैया चंदन लगाए से कवन नर डर गए बकुला न तरे जिनके उजर पर है बकुला न तरे जिनके उजर पर है जो नर दयावंत सोई नर नर है नर दयावंत सोई नर नर करियो जो नर हाँ कठी के बांधे से कवन नर तर गए कठी के बांधे से कवन नर तर गए बैला न तरे जिनके गला ही में हर है बैला न तरे जिनके गला ही में हर जो नर दयावंत सोई नर नार है जो नर दयावंत सोई नर नार है ओ जो नर दयावंत सोई नर नार है गंगा नहाए से कवन नर तर गए हाँ ए भैया गंगा नहाए से कवन नर तर गए मेरह कवाना तरे जिनके जला ही में घर है ए भैया जो नर दयावंत सोई नर नार है जो नर दयावंत सोई नर नार है ओ जो नर
That is a man who has daya. He is considered a human who has mercy in his heart. Chandana lagai se kawana naratari gai. If you put a tika, chandan on your forehead and feel you will be liberated, don't fool yourself. The egret is born white, just like your chandan, and he whole body white, and he didn't get heaven. One drop of tika cannot liberate you. Wait, mala, tulsi, rudraksh, all kind of bead and wood and thing around your neck. Feeling that will liberate you? Well, now young people never see the beauty, eh? But a bhaisa, long ago, the yoke make with wood, and he toting that in his neck and he dragging a whole kyat, a cane, and that didn't liberate him. A piece of wood around your neck, I say, that is a mala go liberate you? No. Going and bathing in the Ganga and saying, oh, all my sin will liberate you. The crapo, he to born inside it, he to dead right there, he didn't go heaven. Murha marai se kawananar tari gai. Bheriyana tare jinke munde sar par hai. You feel if you shave out your head and come as sadhu, you get liberated. The sheep, he poor fella, he like he getting ball. And he get liberated. You ever watch a sheep? You could see his call a little bit, you know, getting ball. He ball head and he get liberated. Jatta ke rakhaye se kawanana retari gai. Some people put on, grow matted locks, long, long hair, and say, oh, I am a sadhu. Morawana tare jinke lambi lambi par hai. The peacock ha long, long feather, and he didn't go heaven. Long hair not going to liberate you. He's a Purani Bhajani, my guru. Hira Das, he's 106 years old, he's still living. My guru, my inspiration. You know, he gave me, after my Aja tell me, after my Aja taught me, he said, you have to go by sadhu to learn. So my guru, who is still alive, I just read with glasses and he just read it out, and he's 106 years. My guru taught me this bhajan. Kahat Kabir, suno bhai sadhu. Kabir Das is telling, listen, no sadhus. Ram naam se sab koi tari gai. Only name of the Lord will liberate you. Forget this costumery and pageantry and gallantry and surrender to God and have in your heart mercy, compassion. This is what makes you a human, nothing else. So he's telling, because mankind in Kali Yuga will become so polluted with vice, they will be dragged into hell. So it's easy to get dragged into hell, my friends. Now you're worried. The Pandit only talking that all are we going to hell? No, I didn't say that. All are we motivated to go to hell? We have the inclination to go to hell because we're born in Kali Yuga. You understand? It doesn't mean you're going to hell, you know. It's a possibility that we could be a reality. But what is the truth? Vyas Muni is telling, listen, your father had come from a great family. But because of the influence of the age, he has done a wrong thing. Nobody in your lineage would take a dead snake and put it around a Brahman neck. Remember Raja Parikshit did that? And he got cursed. But because Kali Yuga influenced him, he performed a wrong action. That in Kali Yuga, good souls will come and try to do good, to live like Treta, to live like Satyug, to live like Dwapar, but the age is an age of darkness and confusion. It will hold down. It will give pressure to that person. That person will have a hard time to succeed in spirituality and to present divinity towards society. But if that person pursues, because he is a divine person, eventually he will get some success, not all, because Kali Yuga is an age of darkness. But that little amount of success he will get to give light to humanity, he will be able to liberate himself and everyone. The light of spirituality is very dim in Kali Yuga. The light of materialism is bright in Kali Yuga. But all that glitters is not his goal. And all that shine is not divine. It's a little light which you have to come close to look at. Where you have to bow your head to see. Will teach you humility, which will be the foundation to receive divinity. The little light. So it's very hard in this age for dharma to always be bright, because too much of sinfulness and evil people are being born. Between the age of Dwapar and Kali, there is a middling period where the ages change over, and there demonic people are going to be born. And when Kali Yuga is coming to an end, and there's a middling, the changing age again from Kali Yuga to Satyuga, divine people will be coming to usher in the Satyuga. And this is why we see children are doing wrong things. And we are asking ourselves, how did children behave in so? But these are the tests for us who want to be divine. Would we say, well, John Hoy, Town Hoy, how it hangs, so it swing? Or would we decide to get up and go and make the change? Vyas Muni is telling, in this age, when souls will suffer because of the sinfulness of the environment and the age of Kali Yuga, where it is easy to do wrong and it is hard to do good, not so? And we just ask, we self that, we talk that with your friends. How them people doing bad thing and they living good? How them people doing evilness and they surviving? And we trying to be good and people beating us down. And always ask ourselves that. I didn't thief. I didn't rob. I didn't say nothing. And look at these people. Why? For this is the age for that. But don't worry, my friends. Those who are acquiring wealth and fame and getting drunk in the illusion of this world, they are going back to where they come from. Hell. What about you and I who are in Mandir? This is what he's speaking about now. The people like you and I. How will we become liberated? Because I am sure those of you are listening or looking at the television, or those of you in the mandir, you know, you ask them, Pandit only saying bad thing, bad thing, bad thing. Then what about we? We trying to be good, we scared now, like, all are we going to hell? No. No, you're not going. I'm not going, for sure. Because I'm afraid to go there. So what will liberate us in Kali Yuga? You see, again we come back to the aarti. We sing in every day. Satyuga Treta Dwapara Madhe Kali Yuga Raja Savaya. She is reigning in the age of Kali. Lord Vishnu, if you did not know, has given up this age, you know. Lord Vishnu, when Kali Yuga come, he said, me, I want to have nothing to do with these people. So he goes to Devi Mata and says, Ma, these people are so confused. I cannot handle them, the sinfulness of them. So Devi Mata says, I will deal with them. I will give them illusion and I will give them redemption. I will let them drown themselves in the ocean of mundane material addiction, or I will be their lifeguard to pull them out. I will give them the choice. For in this age, Vyas is telling, sometime the priesthood will become corrupted. And men who don't believe in God will become the priest. Because it's a lucrative business. many people today should not be pandits. Should not be pandits. But this is the way of the Maya of the mother. If you want to follow this way, go. Because you have to surrender and be humble. This is not about money. The duty of the Brahman is to keep his mind in God. The duty of the Brahman is to give love and teach people to love. The duty of the Brahman is to encourage people to become humble and all embracing. And if you go to a temple where the rich people have more say than the poor people, and the poor people make to wash and cook and clean, then that is not the house of God. In the house of the Lord, there is no recognition for your services. I won't tell you that. Because all of us are serving equally to the same God. You might have the money, I might have the strength. You understand? But at the end of it all, it is one point we are going to. So there is no high and no low in the house of the Lord, and none is better than the other. Sit where you want to sit down, because they have no other seat. That is the house of the Lord, how we must present ourselves. So because of this money and lustfulness, even the priesthood becomes corrupted. So he's telling those in Kali Yuga who will surrender to the Devi, who will worship to her and follow the scriptures and recite her mantras, worship to her, you will become liberated. The highest mantra that you must recite is a Gayatri. Om Bhurabhuaswa Tatsaviturvarenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhyoyo Naha Prachodayat. Om Bhurabhuaswa Tatsaviturvarenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhyoyo Naha Prachodayat. This mantra, Vyas Muni is telling, people have taken it and have not studied it. And if we can study this mantra will give us liberation. Then we must also meditate on the supreme mantra of the Devi, the Mahabij mantra. That is, Om. Say after me, say Om Hrim. Om Hrim. Om Hrim. The Mahabij of the Devi. Reciting that mantra, you begin to bring enlightenment into you. You begin to have peace and truthfulness in you. And you begin to ascend the spiritual ladder. This is what we need to do in Kali Yuga. Introspection, looking within ourselves, study the Gayatri mantra, meditate on its meaning, and use it for our liberation. Never have hate for anyone. Understand. No, I think you are in a better position to understand why people are behaving the way they are. They are being motivated by the age dharma, the Kali Yuga dharma. So we cannot judge them, nor we cannot blame them. We have to accept them for who they are. But we must continue on our pathway. We must continue on our pathway towards liberation. Don't let them destroy our spirit, our peace of mind. Accept them for who they are. Love them for who they are. And move on. For who is hurting you, love them. Who is undermining you, bless them. who is bad talking you, pray for them. Because those are the people who came from hell and who are going back to hell. You just continue on your loving journey towards serving the Lord. Kabir Das says, when an elephant is walking through a market, all the dog could do is bark. Be like the elephant. Don't allow the words and the actions of the evil-minded people to penetrate you. Walk bold and brave towards your destiny, and they will just like be like kukur, like dog, only making noise, because they know if they come too close, they will get destroyed. For if you keep on the pathway towards divine realization, if your enemies come close to hurt you, the Divine Mother will smite them. Just continue in love, continue in peace, and let your enemies do their duty and you do yours. As you always remember, I gave this story many times, an old kahani. The sad who went to bathe in the river, and he see a scorpion sting, drowning and dying inside the river. As he put his hand to take out the scorpion sting him in his hand. And he bawled, ow! And he let go the scorpion, but as the scorpion started drowning again, he hold back the scorpion again, and the scorpion sting him again. A fella watching that, he said, why you let it drown and dead boy? You going to dead too or what? He said, bhai. He said, I doing my duty to save he, and he doing his duty to kill me. So I'm doing mine and he doing his. Continue. Let the scorpion do what they want to do. They might be feeling you go dead, but you ain't go dead. Keep your mind on your God and walk. Yes, your enemies will pain you. Yes, your enemies will hurt you. Sometimes your enemies will bar you. But if you keep your mind on your destination, you will walk. You will walk through the walls that they put in front of you. You will smite those who are blocking you, and those who are, you know, conspiring against you, they will become confused and fight themselves. I guarantee you. You just walk. Walk the journey home to your mother. She will take you to liberation. That when we in this age of Kali, because of sin, are born in this age, if we do good, we will be born in the age of Bhagwan Krishna. And then if we do good in the age, in the new coming age of Bhagwan Krishna in Dwapar, we will be born in the age of Ram, in the second coming of Ram, in the next coming of Ram Chandra. And if we do good in Treta, we will be born in Satyug. And when we are born in Satyug, what will happen? We will get liberation. Liberation is not overnight, but we will be born in a better place, in a better time, where we can become more and more divine. Prem Solo Devi Mata Ki
Jai.
Jai. This is my message tonight. I hope it is encouraging. I hope it is motivating. Don't think about the negativity. Think about your duty and your goal. Be loving. Let us all stand as we have aarti. Prem Solo Durga Maiya Ki
पर्वत वासिनी तेरा पारण पाया, तेरा पारण पाया, गाओ
सुनो मेरी देवी पर्वत वासिनी तेरा पारण पाया, तेरा पारण पाया।
रूप दीप नहीं बेरारती
अरे मोहन मोहन लगा
मैया तेरे गुण गावे,
भानुभगत मैया तेरे गुण गावे,
भानुभगत मैया तेरे गुण गावे,
भानुभगत मैया तेरे गुण गावे।
अरे मन बांछित फल पाया, मन बांछित फल पाया,
तो सुनो मेरी देवी पर्वत वासिनी तेरा पार न पाया, तेरा पार न पाया,
तो
सुनो मेरी देवी पर्वत वासिनी तेरा पार न पाया, तेरा पार न पाया,
अरे तेरा पार न पाया, अरे तेरा पार न पाया। देवी माता की
जय।
Let us clasp our hands and close our eyes as we give thanks to Bhagwan, Divine Mother Durga, for allowing us to be here tonight. And also to Divine Mother for blessing us with one of your devotional bhaktas, Srimati Rukmini Bipatji, who came to sing with us today. May Bhagwan bless her and give her the strength and the protection to always be on the roads, as she is one of the pillars of the Sanatana Dharma in Trinidad, singing in weddings and jagyas and so, keeping our tradition alive. May Bhagwan bless her. May Bhagwan bless Dr. Tariq, his mom, his stepdad, Dr. John Suchong, Auntie Sandra, and the whole Suchong Dukhi family for giving us this blessing this year of Devi Ma, that we can all enjoy and worship to her. We pray, O Bhagwan, that Lord, Divine Mother Durga, you know our hearts and our minds, you know our troubles, you know our desires, our aspirations, you know everything we don't even know. We throw ourselves at your mercy, O Mother. Save us, embrace us, liberate us, as we pray as a family. Hari Om. Mantrahinam kriyahinam bhaktihinam janardanam yat pujitam maya deva paripurnam tarastame tvameva mata cha pita tvameva tvameva bandho
Shanti.
दुर्गा मैया की
जय,
महालक्ष्मी मैया की
जय,
शारदा माता की, श्री कलकतिया काली माता की,
मां पति महादेव की जय, पवन सुत हनुमान की जय, सियावर रामचंद्र की जय, उड़ीसा जगन्नाथ की जय, वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय, सियावर रामचंद्र की जय, शरणम
सत्य सनातन धर्म की
जय,
सत्य सनातन धर्म की
जय,
सत्य सनातन धर्म की
जय,
सद्गुरु की दंडवत जय जय
सीताराम।
And so blessings to all of you, and again blessings to my wife as she celebrates her birthday today.